Here we go. Let's ride. Hey boys, hey girl, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. This channel is all about cooking. I guess you already know if you've been following it for any length of time. And to cook, we've got to shop. We got to go out and buy the groceries to cook the meals. So let's go over a couple things. Grocery stores use some sneaky little scams. Some you may know of, some you may not. The supermarkets are designed to get us to spend as much money as possible. They're not concerned as much with our waistlines or our health. The manufacturers are not. They're concerned with their bottom line more than anything at all. Thanks to psychological tricks of the manufacturers, we're most likely getting cheated or at least manipulated into spend more every time we walk in the door at a grocery store. Let's go over some of these sneaky tricks. They'll have fresh baked breads and cookies and cakes and all this kind of stuff when some people or some of them actually do bake these things themselves. The odors waft through the air to enhance you to go over there and buy them. Yum, snack right now. Eat it while it's hot. Sometimes those products are shipped in frozen. They may either thaw them and bake them or thaw them and just package them. Those cookies and cakes and things they bake, look for the nutrition labels on those and see how much extra junk is in them. Is that really a healthy cookie because it's oatmeal? Wonder how much sugar or corn syrup's in it. If you'd have baked it at home, you would know what's in it. I'm not trying to go totally health nut, but I'm just saying you really don't know. They may have stuff like, what's that real, real unhealthy oil? Is it palm oil? No. It's one of them. Maybe coconut oil. I forget. One of them is really, really bad. High in the bad fats. And they'll make them baked junk food look like gourmet snacks and things. Yeah. Stay away from the buffets in them grocery stores. You know, if you're in a hurry to go in and get a meal or something late at night or getting off late from work, you don't have time to cook, get one of their rotisserie chickens or something like that. You'd be a lot better off in a couple vegetables. You can steam them, burl them. I'll eat them raw, like carrots, whatever. Spices, they'll trick you on certain spices. Like paprika, for instance, may actually be made from leftovers from other spices. So you gotta watch what you buy. Same with juices. A lot of juices, especially orange juice and pomegranate juice. Orange juice is mostly cut with water. And like pomegranate juice are cut with other juices like apple to increase the volume. Cool, huh? Honey, same way with honey. They cut honey with corn syrup. So your best bet would be to know somebody that's got a beehive or a bee farm and buy the honey directly from him. That's the way to do it. Same way with certain meats. You ever seen enhanced a saline added or solution added to pork or beef or turkey, for instance? They inject in water into it to jack up increase the weight, and you're paying for that, and it's not doing anything for you. except you're spending more money on it than what you should be. Olive oils, they're cutting those too. And even a real oil connoisseur, it's hard for them to tell the difference between real olive oil and taste-wise now. Smell-wise, a different story. Fresh olive oil has got a fruity smell, where some of the stuff you buy in the store don't hardly have any smell at all because it's cut with some other junk, just other oils. Who cares? If they can make more money, that's what it's all about. That's the name of the game. A boy, they'll put the more expensive items at eye level. So kind of look around when you're shopping for stuff. You may find the brand you're looking for up high or down low, or they like to put those high dollar items right at eye level. That's a little scam that all of them use. They do that on purpose. I've actually seen some of them tend to hide some of the cheaper stuff that tastes just as good. Or maybe healthier for you because they got less salt in it. Some estimates, manufacturers shell out $100 billion a year in shelf fees to represent their products and have them placed in the center where they want to make as much money from them as they can. How about that? Another thing they'll do is rearrange the aisles. Once you just got to know your grocery store, they swap everything around in an attempt to introduce new products that make more money for them that they want you to buy. Another deal that they found out was that most customers, the majority of people, shop counterclockwise in a grocery store. And the best thing to do is to go down and shop for their produce first. You want to shop for your produce last, your fresh produce, your fruits and vegetables and things last. And go all around the outside of the store first before starting to go down the aisles. Because you naturally the milk and stuff is going to be way in the back of the store. They do that on purpose. You in a hurry, you're home, getting home from work, you just need some milk and eggs, let's say. And you got to walk all the way to the back of the damn store to get that. And they do that on purpose because they put those all kind of snack shit and other items in there they want you to buy. You come out, oh, look, here's a snack I could eat on the way home. That's a little scam, trick, ploy thing that they do. And like I said, they do it on the candy aisle. Oh, let's go down to candy aisle. Shut up, phone. They'll use the end caps of the aisles to entice you to buy the high profit margin items like sodas and chips and snack foods. And you have signs and all kind of cool looking stuff out there. When you can find better deals by searching high and low on the aisles yourself. The pre-cut produce scam is convenient if you're in a hurry. You can save a whole lot of dollars just buying the fruit yourself and cutting it up and all. The 99 cent scam, every $6.99. Oh, that's cheaper than $7.10. Or $7. The brain don't see that. The brain sees that $6.99, oh, that's cheap. Because it's less than that next dollar, rounded off to the next dollar. It's not a little psychological trick they try to pull. The free sample thing. They walk around, do you want to taste this? Yeah. Man, this is good cheese, or good whatever. You look little brownies or something. They charging a premium price for that. Buy what you came in to buy and skip all the other garbage. You got to plan your strategy. And limited time. Oh, limited time only. Why? Is it fitting to go out of season? Or is it just not selling, so we're going to try to unload it on you to get it off our shelves and we can at least make something off of it? They pull all kind of crap like that. Use cash when you go to the grocery store. They did they published an article about from the Journal of Consumer Research and tracked shoppers' habits of 1,000 households over 6 months. And they found the ones who paid cash bought fewer processed goods and more nutritious items than those who used credit. The explanation is the credit and debit cards are more abstract forms of payment. So we don't use them as carefully as we do cash. Cool, huh? Snack before you shop, or have lunch before you shop, or breakfast or something. Know your grocery store, too. I mean, like I said, if you're going in for the eggs and milk, go straight there, wear blinders, don't look around. If that's all you want, they got signs. Surprise, they don't have flashing lights a mariachi band in there playing music by this new Mexican product or something. You know, watch, that'll be coming up next. Shop on Wednesdays. Why? Wednesdays, people who shop on Saturday and Sunday mornings, that's when they're most crowded. Wednesdays is the best day to shop, in America, anyway. I don't know. You know, so bring your reading glasses so you can read them labels. Look for unknown brands. Maybe something local you can look at.
High sugar, high dollar snacks are on the bottom shelf, so kids see them first.
Produce. A lot of fresh produce, boy, it looks all pretty. It got wax sprayed on it to make it shiny. Oranges, for instance, may have orange dye applied to the outside of them. And a lot of the fresh vegetables that look really, really good may not be the freshest at all. Some of them, like real oranges, they have little blemishes on the skin. Pick it up and smell it and see what it smells like. You can feel the flesh of it and you can tell if it's fresh by touching and feeling and smelling it. Subpar conventional produce is bred to look waxy, glistening, and perfectly symmetrical. While prime fruits and vegetables are often irregularly shaped with slight visual imperfections outside, but a world of flavor is waiting inside. And you can kind of tell by the skin, the taut skin and peels are a telltale sign of freshness. And shop in season, too. If you can't, then buy frozen. Frozen foods or a good bet. Matter of fact, if you're not going to eat a vegetable tomorrow that you bought today, let's say, then buy it frozen. It'll keep until you're ready for it, because there's a lot of vegetables that lose their vitamins and things. Fresh vegetables lose their vitamins and things very, very fast. Spinach, for one. Some vegetables will hold for a long time, like onions and cabbage, apples and fruits, also some apples and things. You know, whereas other fruits like, what is it, bananas, they go bad pretty rapidly. Avocados do. There's a trick with avocado. If you take the avocado and pull where the stem was attached to it out, pick that little stub piece of stem out and look. If it's green, avocado's good. If it's brown inside, avocado ain't no good. Don't buy it. Throw it at your grocer. When you can, buy local produce. They have some vegetable markets here that they buy local products. All local produce and things like that are sold. And it may be slightly more expensive, but it sure do taste better, and it's fresh. Linger around in the produce aisle some. Check out everything they got. You never know. Buy your lettuce last. Why? Well, they did another research thing that in shoppers shopping in counterclockwise patterns. The research shows that shoppers who do produce first spend more money and time in the rest of the store. And when you go to buy fish, maybe there's some fish on sale, fresh fish. It's on sale. Ooh, well, wait a minute. How fresh is it? It may be on sale because it's fitting to go past its expiration date. When you're buying fish, think small fish. Smaller fish tend to have less mercury in them than the larger fish do. So it's just the way it is. Sardines, anchovy, Atlantic mackerel are all lower in contaminations than their larger predators like swordfish, shark, swordfish, and shark. Wild meats also, like, what is it? Ostrich, bison, venison, and elk contain as much protein and iron as beef, pork, but has less fat and fewer calories. I guess I should add, a lot of y'all have asked, where do I buy this? Where do I buy that? If you can't get it directly from the manufacturer's website, like Camellia sells direct, and these manufacturers that do have online stores ship or actually have a commercial discount rate on shipping with say USPS or and or FedEx or UPS, because they ship so much. And that would be your better bet. Usually Amazon charges a little extra fee when you order directly from them. So that always check your manufacturer site if you're looking for something. And grocery items I'm talking about, Some of y'all have asked about crawfish. Where do I get live crawfish, frozen crawfish tails? Tony Seafood up on Plank Road here in Baton Rouge ships, nationwide. And I hadn't had their boudin before, but I have had Pouchet's boudin. And they ship nationwide as well. And they have a few shipping items, like you can either have it delivered to your door or you go pick it up at the airport because it's coming air freight overnight, these frozen items are. And it's cheaper to go to the airport and get it rather than having it delivered to your door. There's some manufacturers that don't ship. And, there's some online Cajun grocery places, Amazon for one. And they all charge extra fees, as I previously mentioned. I can ship you something non-perishable, but I don't have a discounted commercial rate on it. I can ship flat rate and USPS flat rate, which, for dry goods, beans, seasonings, stuff like that, I think that the starting price on their shipping flat rate is going to be, what is it? They just went up. Is it $7.20? You look on UPS's site and you can see the different options for boxes and padded envelopes, which are recommended for shipping. A lot of you folks also have been chiming in saying, hey, I found this brand over here in California or up in Chicago or on the East Coast. And they're starting to, you know, branch out some of these products. But I know of some that are not shipped out of state. You can't even get them in adjoining states around Louisiana. Just dry package good products that are really good. So the big box stores probably won't have them. You should go to the smaller stores in your area. Specialty stores may stock them. Little mom and pops are found like in, or I've been told in California, say the LA area, where they had a product that they saw me using on in one of my videos. So you should check those. And a lot of times they don't know where to put them, where to stock them at on the shelves. So you may have to ask, always ask. And you can always tell your grocer, hey, get me some of this. I'll buy half a case or, you know. And if you get some friends to go in there and do it too, they may go ahead and start stocking it, especially if it sells, which it should, if you know how to follow directions. So I hope I can put this together and make it make some sense in the editing. We'll see what happens. Now, my oldest daughter, Brandy, while she was staying here, told me about this product, and it is better than some of the name brand frozen Philly cheesesteak items that they sell. And so I made some, and they come out great. I use that little sizzle cue. That's on my stovetop. I got a gas stovetop, I guess you ought to know. But they sell them in different sizes, from Little Griddle Inc. And if you get the right size, it'll fit down and inside your gas barbecue pit. And it works really well. Sliders, burgers, whatever you want. You can cook eggs, bacon on it if you'd like. Hot dogs, grilled veggies. The sky's the limit. That's what cooking's about, right? Right. Hoo boy, hoo girl, hoo bye.